All right, so what I need you to do for the next 5 days is to track all your mornings and evening activities. I want you to take actually good notes of exactly what you're doing every single morning when you wake up for the first 4 to 8 hours, and also before you go to bed. What are you doing for the last 4 to 8 hours of your day? I want you to really take a good analysis of what is going on. What's going on, everybody? My name is Salim Sunni, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Here I help individuals such as yourself be more motivated, discover their purpose, and understand that you are God's very best. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing. And also, when you do subscribe, make sure you click on the notification button so you get some of the upcoming videos as well. We've been talking about for the next 90 days how you can be able to be successful while you're in the school year. The reason why we talk about 90 days is not that I'm gonna give you stuff for the next 90 days. I'm gonna give you skills that I want you to apply in the next 90 days. 90 days is because we want you to build positive and successful habits. Someone said that if you do something for 21 days straight, it will often become a habit because you're doing it like that. Well, the reason why some of these skills, you're not gonna be doing each of them every single day. So that's why we give you 90 days, so you have enough time to practice them. And the good thing is, whether it's a trimester or a semester format, one of the things is after 90 days, you have somewhat of a break for you to step back and assess your progress. Today, I want to help you become more accountable. So you're in school, so you've decided to come and want to acquire more knowledge, whether your parents are forcing you to come, whether you as a spouse, you know, you talk with your wife, talk with your children to come back into school to get a degree, maybe in the later part of your life. Maybe you're in school, you have big goals, you want to achieve something, you want to become an engineer, a nurse, a surgeon, you want to be a politician, whatever the case may be, and you need to understand the importance of coming to get an education. Like, some of you guys have many different goals, right? You don't all each have the same goals. I want you to really take a good look at the goals that you have, and here what I want you to do. For the next 2 to 5 days, I really want you to go and actually start tracking and analyzing your daily routines. Why is this so important? See, your daily routine will affect how your results will end up being. So we've talked plenty enough about how your belief level affects your action, and your action and then affects your results. You see, action, when they're repeated through repetition of the same activities over and over, they create certain results, and those actions done over and over become habits, right? But you want to track those habits. Some of us don't have so many good habits. Sometimes there are negative habits. We want to be able to be analyze them for ourselves. The reason why accountants get paid so much is because often enough, like entrepreneurial business people, we don't always look at the numbers, right? But an accountant looks at our spending pattern, to look at, you know, how much money is coming in, what we're spending it on. See, and that's why they get paid as much as they do. So I want you to become an accountant for your life. Here's one thing that is actually practical. Anyone can do this. You don't have to be good at math. Trust me, this has nothing to do with math. But for the first 4 to about 8 hours of your day, right? So when you wake up, in the morning, I want you to start counting, what do you do, right? So when you get out of the bed, the first thing you do is check your phone, right? Are you on the gram? And if you're on Instagram or on Snapchat and you're like on there for an hour, I want you to write down Instagram 1 hour. Right? If you're on Facebook and you're scrolling for the next 30 minutes, you run also Facebook 30 minutes. Like, I want you to track everything, right? Get ready in the morning. You go to class. I want you to track. You know what I mean? Got ready. Took me 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Went to class. I want you to do that. Like, after you do this 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, 4 day, 5 days, you can start looking at, okay, what are some of the things I do consistently every day? And how is that affecting me? Maybe some of you guys, after you start looking at, you know, your progression for the next 5 days, you'll realize there are some things you don't even do consistently. Like, sometimes you wake up at 8, sometimes you wake up at 12, sometimes you wake up at 6 a.m., sometimes you're like, you go to sleep at 6 a.m. Like, you know, you're all over the place. You're all over the place, but you don't know it because you haven't really looked at it. But some of you guys will realize that there's some things you're doing that are actually helping you, but you don't know what they are because you haven't not analyzed them. There's a certain time when you do study that is the optimal amount of time where you gain the most information, but you don't know what that time is. You just happen to see that you're studying the most, and that has an impact on your grade when you study between 11 a.m. and 12 a.m. and 12 p.m. right? From 11 to noon, or sometimes it's like from 1 to 4, or maybe it is for that 15 minutes when you are on the bus on your way to class. Like, it could be many different things, but I do want you to start taking an analysis of your day. This is only going to be doing for 2 to 5 days. Now, some of you guys might be like, okay, listen, I go to school really at night. So what I want you to do is to take an analysis of the end of your day. Well, like, what do you do that is related to the school and how does that affect you? Like, for example, before you start going to class, like, what are some of the things that you do? Do you eat? And then do you like commute for an hour? Do you live on campus? And do you talk with your roommates? Do you spend some time? Like, I really want you to start taking an analysis and look from afar. What do you do for your day? When you do finish doing this for the next 2 to 5 days, here's what I want you to do. If you can, I want you to take a picture with your cell phone or whatever the case may be of what you do for your day. And I want you to be able to email this for me. Like, listen, you don't have to put your name on there. I don't have to know what you are. Like, the reason why I want you to do this is I want you to remain accountable to doing this exercise, right? So I want you to take a picture. I want you to take a picture of what you're doing right now. Take the picture and send it to this email, contact@salemsunday.com. I want you to send that the picture to that email address so that I can use that and we'll randomly select one winner to get a special gift. Now, if it's on your phone, take a screenshot. If it's on your computer, take some kind of a screenshot of that and email it to me directly. Go to contact@salemsunday.com. The reason why I'm saying this is I want you to stay accountable to this exercise. It's definitely going to help you, right? Remember, every single day for the first 4 hours, right? It could be literally from 6 a.m. to 7 a.m., from 7 a.m. to 8 a.m., from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m., from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. So from 6 to 10, what do you do there? And for some of you guys, you realize that this is so helpful, you start doing them almost every week. And then you'll start looking at the pattern of like a whole month. Like, what do you do? And how you can be able to change some of those patterns as well. But listen, that's all for me today. Remember, if you want to make sure that you continue on this success series that we're doing, make sure you subscribe to the page and also click that notification button so you don't miss any upcoming videos. Share this with someone else who can also find some value into this. Remember, you're God's very best. I'll see you next time.